A very good morning, students. Today in this session of human values, we'll be continuing with the previous topic that we're doing, that harmony in the family, and we'll talk about the various values in a relationship. So as you already know that there are certain basic and important values in maintaining relationships. So these values, you all know, are the backbone of healthy and happy family relations. So the feelings, the emotions, the sentiments, the respect, all are of importance. So these values lead to elimination of friction and establishment of total harmony in relationship on the basis of a long term. So values that are important in any relationship are, we already talked about it, they are trust, we have affection, we have care, we have guidance, we have reverence, you have glory, gratitude and love. So we start with the first one, that is the foundation value, that is trust. So trust is known as the foundation value, or in Hindi as we call it vishwas. So trust is to be assured that each human being inherently wants oneself and the other to be happy and prosperous. So if we have trust in the other, we are able to see the other as a relative and not as an adversary to us. So trust is to be assured that the other human being wants to make me happy and prosperous. In this, so we should be able to differentiate between intention and competence. And these are the two components of trust. Intention is one, is always to make the other happy. And competence is that the intention of the other is always to make happy. Mostly people's competence is lacking, which has to be improved. So if we verify the following sentences. I want to make myself happy. Just verify it. I want to make the other happy. The others want to make himself, her or herself happy. The other wants to make me happy. So we try to find out the answer. I am able to make myself happy. We do not. So we'll try. And it is a question mark that. So if we talk about 1A, 2A, 3A. So we are very much confirmed that it is that we want to make myself happy, we may want to make the other happy, and the other also wants to make himself or herself happy. But if we talk about 4A, that the other wants to make me happy, we have a doubt over there. Now if we talk about the answers, what is the answer? I am able to make myself happy. Actually, there is a confusion whether we are always able to make ourselves happy. Then if we talk about the answer for 2A, I am able to make the other always happy. That is also a question mark, that whether we are always able to make the other happy or not. There is a doubt on that also. We talk about 3A and 4A. In all these questions, you will see that we are falling short somewhere. We are not able to make myself also happy every time. And we are also not able to make the others also every time happy. So where are we falling short? So we'll now understand the meaning between intention and competence. So you can see that the question number 1A, 2A, 3A and 4A are actually our intention, that is our natural acceptance. So what we really want to be, that I want to make myself happy. So I want to make the other also happy. The others want to make myself or himself happy. So actually this is our natural acceptance, which we really want to be. But we fail to do so. Why? Because we lack in our ability to fulfill those things. So that is our competence. I'm able to make myself happy. There is a doubt. I'm able to make the other always happy. That is also doubtful. The other is able to make himself always happy. We are having confusion. The other is able to make me always happy. There is also a question mark. So that is the competence, that where are you falling short? And actually, so that is known as what we are actually doing. So that is the competence. So the first questions are related to our natural acceptance, that is our intention. And the next four to our competence. So to be assured that the intention of the other is always correct is trust. We generally evaluate ourselves on the basis of our intention, that is our natural acceptance. We think that we are good as our intentions are good, and the other on the basis of their competence. I take the example that by mistake, if I've broken a glass, I will say that I did not wish to break the glass. It was not my intention to break the glass. The glass broke accidentally. But if somebody else breaks the glass, we'll say that it was his intention to break the glass. He did not take care of the glass and so it fell down and it broke. So when you're measuring ourselves, we're measuring ourselves on the basis of intention. Whereas when we're evaluating the other person, we're evaluating the other person on the basis of their competence. So if we have trust on intention, we have a feeling of being related to the other. And we start helping the other to improve his competence if he does not have the competence. When there is a lack of trust, it is the most serious matter in our interpersonal relationships. The feeling of trust in a relationship can be ensured for everyone with right understanding of intention. This is the foundation of a relationship. A relationship without trust results in opposition and the relationship gets shaken up. So trust is to be assured that the other human being wants to make me happy and prosperous. So we have already talked that we have two parts in this, that is intention and competence. So one should be able to differentiate between intention and competence. Intention is one is always to make the other happy. Thus the intention of other is also to make me happy. So mostly people's competence is lacking, which has to be improved. And when we are assured of the intention of the other and find that the competence is lacking, we become a help to the other. When we doubt the intention of the other, we get into opposition. So you can clarify the following sentences. How can I trust a stranger? How can I trust someone who has bad intentions? I know someone's character is not good. How can I trust someone like that? If I trust everyone, will people take advantage of me? This person can never be trusted. Be careful of that person. Never trust anyone blindly. So these are the various questions which come to our mind, and we can actually clarify, we'll try to clarify this on the basis of your natural acceptance. So as we try to clarify about our intention and competence, we can explore that whether we're trying to improve the competence of the other person. If we're trying to improve the competence of the other person, that means we have the trust on his intention. So this is, we respond to their problems. And when you have the doubt on their intention, we get into opposition and we start reacting on their proposals. We get irritated on them, we get angry at them, we have a feeling of opposition in case we do not trust their intention, and we, that is why accordingly we give reactions. So if we try to clarify this particular question, if you have trust on everybody, people will take undue advantage of you. What is the basic error in the statement? The basic error is that if you trust everybody, people will not take undue advantage of me. On the contrary, it will give me inner strength and we become far more effective in interacting with the dealing with different people. This is simply because we are already sitting with the knowledge of what a person truly wants, truly intends, even though the person may not know this himself or herself. Or in other words, we can say that becoming aware, having the right understanding, living with the assurance in relationship does not mean becoming stupid. It only makes us more competent. Further, what is being said here is what we have trust on the intention of everyone. But when it comes to making a program with someone, I evaluate my competence. I evaluate his competence and make the program accordingly. So this makes me more effective. So another question that we are trying to clarify, how can I trust a stranger? So every human being, including strangers, have the same natural acceptance that as I am having. So however, the competence may or may not be present. For a stranger, we may need time to evaluate their competence, but not to know their natural acceptance. So the person has natural acceptance for the same things as we are having. He or she too wants to make himself or herself happy at the level of his intention, just as we want to make. But we are unaware. So we evaluate the other person at the level of his competence. Then there is discontinuity of trust. We doubt the other person and cause a sense of opposition. As opposition is not acceptable to us, it creates a contradiction. So you must relate to the other person at the level of natural acceptance. We can interact at the level of competence and help to improve the competence. So trust is developed over a long time, true for competence, but it is true for trust on natural acceptance, that is your intention. Never trust blindly, we have to trust on the intention, that is the natural acceptance of the person, and evaluate their competence before making a program with them. Thus, we can summarize that I am able to accept the other as like me only. We have the same intention, and like me, he also may be lacking in competence. With trust on intention, I feel related to the other person, and with that at the base, I make a program based on our current mutual competence. Relationship is founded on trust. So in the absence of it, we do not feel related to the other, and the relationship keeps shaking. So common mistake in relationship is to evaluate myself based on the intention and evaluate the other based on competence. Now you come to the next value in relationship, that is respect. Respect means right evaluation. The respect is a value in relationship. When people have this feeling of respect out of understanding of relationship, it remains there all the time continuously. It is the state of harmony between one human and the other human. Respect comes if people live with a sense of responsibility with the other. By ensuring mutual fulfillment, people accept the responsibility to improve the understanding of the other. To be in news, mostly people try to win awards, they try to climb mountains, try to drive in the oceans. Why? Because we're trying to gain attention and we think that it is respect. We try to do various type of things so that we're able to get some attention, because we have mistaken respect and attention as the same thing. So respect is right evaluation. So the need of I is that I should be evaluated as I am. I should evaluate others as they are. If I don't do this, it is disrespect. When people have the feelings of respect out of understanding of relationship, it remains there all the time. Respect comes if people live with sense of responsibility. So respect is right evaluation. And disrespect is, in this we have three things. That is over-evaluation. That is adhimulana. To evaluate more than what it is. When we start praising somebody, okay, maybe he is not capable of such a praise, but we start praising such for something that he has done, and over the things that he has done. So that is over evaluation. So that this might result in an ego in that particular person. Then under evaluation, that is avmoolena, to evaluate less than what it is. A person is trying hard to do something, but still we're saying that this person is not doing anything. He is actually good for nothing. So that is under evaluation or avmoolena. We sometimes call, this person is actually a stupid person. He is not capable of anything. So that is otherwise evaluation, avmoolana. So avmoolana or avmoolana can cause you depression, whereas over evaluation can cause ego in the particular person. So the other is similar to me, you have to understand that. And the difference could only be at the level of understanding. So over evaluation, under evaluation, and otherwise evaluation is disrespect. So we feel disrespected when we are wrongly evaluated. So for respect, you have to understand that our purpose is the same, our program is also the same, and our potential is also the same. We have the same natural acceptance to live with continuous happiness and prosperity. We have to understand the harmony at all the levels of living, and we have the same natural acceptance and desired thought and expectations are going on continuously in me also and the other person also. Then only if we're able to understand that other person is similar to me, then we'll be able to give respect to the person. These are the various bases of differentiation. We differentiate on the basis of body, we differentiate on the basis of physical facility, we differentiate on the basis of beliefs. And we assume that we are giving respect on the basis of these differentiations. So on the basis of body, we give respect. If we talk about age, we give respect to a person who is of old age. We never think that a child, a smaller, younger child also wants respect. So according to the age, we are respecting the person. We give respect according to the race, that is your skin color, your characteristics. The blacks are treated as slaves because of the skin color. So we are respecting the whites because of their skin color. So we are distinguishing on the basis of body and differentiating on the basis of body. Then you have physical strength. A person who is actually very strong, we start respecting that person as compared to a weak person. So we are differentiating on the basis of physical strength. Now if we talk about physical facility, there you have wealth and post. So a person who is very rich, we start respecting that person. And we actually do not give respect to a person who is poor. Accordingly to the post, if a person is on a higher post or a higher designation, we start respecting that person. And as long as that particular person is in that post, we give him respect. Then you have beliefs. In beliefs, we have isms, sects, and information. Isms, you have casteism, you have communism, you have socialism. A person who is actually belonging to socialism, he will not like to speak to a person who is belonging to capitalism or communism. Then you have various religious sects are there. So we do not wish to mix with the people, or we do not wish to listen to the people or respect the people who are belong to other sects. On the basis of information, a person who is a doctor will like to speak to his doctor friend apart from his engineer person, because they can share the information. So we're respecting on the basis of information or beliefs. So these are the various bases actually where you are differentiating, and with thinking that this differentiation is actually respect. So, but this is actually differentiation is actually resulting into disrespect. So, this is the present scenario of respect. So what are the main problems that are arising in relationship because of the differentiation? We have, when you are differentiating on the base of gender, we have female feticide, we have women's organizations which keep on protesting. When you are differentiating on the basis of race, we have racial discrimination, we have racial attacks, we have civil rights movements. When you're differentiating on the basis of age, you have protests and movements demanding for equal rights for children. And we have also, on the other hand, we want equal rights for elderly people. When you're differentiating on the basis of wealth, there is class struggle that you can be seen between the poorer class and the richer class. When you're when we're differentiating based on post, protests against high-handed government officials are there at the level of individuals. It leads to depression. Differentiation on the basis of isms. We have fights, we have turmoils, we have terrorism and war, people converting from one ism to another in order to be able to get more respect. Differentiation on the basis of sects, countless religions and sects, and each sect has its own movement to ensure that there is no discrimination against people of their belief, and demands for special provisions in jobs and in education. So in order to gain respect, we try to do many types of things. We eat hot chilies so that the people will see us on television. We put all types of fashionable clothes. We shave our heads. We color our hair. We earn a lot of money. So simple fact is that we are getting only attention from this. We cannot ensure the feeling of respect from all these attention-seeking activities. So what is the way out? So the way out is to move beyond differentiation. We have to begin to understand that human being is a coexistence of the self and the body, and then base our evaluation on the basis of the self, where we will find that we are similar to the other in terms of our natural acceptance. Third value in relationship is affection. So affection is the feeling of being related to the other. Affection comes when I recognize that we both want to make each other happy and both of us are similar. The next one, care. Care has two things in this. The feeling of responsibility to nurture and protect the body of my relative is care. And secondly, the feeling of responsibility toward the self of my relative. So caring is actually talking about the nurturing the body as well as feeling responsibility toward the self of my relative. So that is care. Then you have guidance, the feeling of ensuring right understanding and feelings in the self of my relative. We understand the need of self for right understanding and feelings. We also understand that the other is similar to me and is our odd faculty of natural acceptance, desire of wanting continuous happiness, and the program of living in harmony at all the four levels. Then we have reverence. So the feeling of acceptance of excellence in the other is called reverence. When we see that the other has achieved this excellence, which means to understand and to live in harmony at all levels of living, ensuring continuity of happiness, we have a feeling of reverence for him or her. Then is glory. Each of us want to live with continuous happiness and prosperity. So each one of us has a similar faculty of natural acceptance, has the same goal and program, and we have the same potential to realize this. So glory is the feeling for someone who has made efforts for excellence. Then gratitude, it is the feeling of acceptance for those who have made efforts for my excellence. So gratitude is an emotion that occurs after people receive help depending on how they interpret the situation. Then you have gratitude. Gratitude is the feeling of acceptance for those who have made efforts for my excellence. So gratitude is an emotion that occurs after people receive help dependent on how they have interpreted the situation. Deed value is love. So love is the emotion of strong affection and personal attachment. In other words, love is a feeling of warm personal attachment or deep affection as a parent, child or a friend. So the feeling or value is also called the complete value, since this is the feeling of relatedness to all human beings. It starts with identifying that one is related to the other human being. The feeling of affection, and it slowly expands to the feeling of being related to all human beings. So we can say that love is the feeling of being related to all. It can be expressed in the form of kindness, beneficence and compassion. Kindness is to provide a resource that the other needs but for which we does not have the competency. Maybe physical facility, maybe relationship or right understanding. Beneficence is to provide something that the other requires but has not felt the need for it. For example, he may require right understanding. Compassion means that one is willing to extend help to the other unconditionally. So now we talk about the basis of an undivided society or Akhanda Samaj. So the feeling of being related to every human being leads to our participation in an undivided society. By living a relationship in the family, we get the occasion to gain the assurance that the other person is an aid to me and not a hindrance. The family is a laboratory of sorts, you can say, in which we live our understanding and relationships. So with the understanding of values in human relationship, we are able to recognize the connectedness with every individual correctly and fulfill it. On getting assured, it becomes easy to see that society is an extension of family and that it is possible to live in harmony with every human being, thus laying the foundation for an undivided society from family to the world family. But if we look at our living nowadays, it is largely in what we can call as reaction mode and not in the response mode. For want of proper understanding of relationship, we keep reacting to the behavior of the other. We are at the mercy of the situation. Only when you're able to recognize the relationship in terms of appropriate values, we'll be responding to every situation and to every person in the right way. So what is response and reaction in a behavior? When you've decided how to behave based on the behavior of the other person, it is reaction. It depends on whether you like or dislike the taste of the behavior of the other person. So if the other behaves properly, you also behave properly. If the other misbehaves, you also misbehave. So your behavior is decided by the other. So you are enslaved. You have doubt on the intention of the other. You get excited or hurt by their behavior. You don't consider mutual happiness and mutual development as a part of a responsibility in the relationship. So that is in the reaction mode. So in this condition, our conduct becomes indefinite. Now, if we talk about response, so you have decided how to behave on your own right. So it is based on right understanding and right feeling in yourself, which are definite. Your behavior is always for mutual happiness. You decide your own behavior. You are self-organized. You are very clear about the intention of the other person. You are neither hurt nor excited by the behavior of the other person. So their behavior is an input to rightly evaluate their competence. So you take responsibility for mutual happiness and mutual development. So your conduct becomes definite. So that is the response. We can have definite conduct only when we start responding to the behavior of the other person. For this, we have to understand that our program is same, our intention is the same. We have the same type of a natural acceptance. And everybody, me or he or she, all of us actually want to have continuous happiness and prosperity. So students, this is all from my side for today's lecture. So we'll meet in the next lecture with another new topic. Thank you, students.